Hello again, Bill Pfeiffer speaking. So very, very good to be with you. Happy Easter. We are an Alleluia people, says Augustine. And that's really the truth. If you can subscribe, here my son Bob, who's my producer on this podcast, says that somehow or other that ends up helping us in some way or other. For the last 59 years, I'll be ordained 59 years on May 11th, so it's coming up very soon. Sunday or Saturday evening, I have been reading for 59 years these words of Augustine, dealing with Easter, the resurrection. Oh, happy days are here. The resurrection of Christ, says Augustine, was God's supreme and holy, marvelous work. Boy, if we could just put that in our pipe and smoke it for a while, what a thing that would do. What that would do to us, you know? That would make things really happen inside of us if we made it real. You know, made that really be something that really is essential in our lives. I was reading the other day as well in Easter Sunday evening in the office, and these words from Saint Peter, really good words. God our Father, by raising Christ your Son, you conquered the power of death and opened for us the way to eternal life. Let our celebration today raise us up and renew our lives by the Spirit that is within us. Ah, what a wonderful word, huh? What a wonderful word. I once heard a story that really touched my heart. It was a story about a fellow by the name of John, who from the Midwest, about 28, 30 years old, and a successful businessman at that time already. And he wanted to take a six-week trip to Europe and went to his travel agent. The travel agent planned things out. He was going to start in southern Italy and work his way north. John said to him, no, I want to land in Bremen. His last name was Schmidt. He was German, and he wanted to go back to the town in which he was born. And so after going back and forth, the travel agent finally decided to book him on a flight to go to Bremen, and John did. He flew into Bremen, and once there, he made his way to the church that he went to as a little boy. Knocked on the rectory door there and got the priest to come over and open up the church and to actually unlock also the baptistry. And the priest is wondering, what is going on here? You know, he can't figure this out. What does this fellow really want? And John went in and kissed the baptismal font and said out loud, here I found my Lord Jesus Christ. Here I found my Lord Jesus Christ. He recognized that once upon a time, some people brought him in, his parents and his godparents, as this tiny little baby, and they made a profession of faith for him. And on that day, all kinds of marvelous things happened for him that were made possible as the result of the resurrection of Jesus. You know, John knew that he was now a son of the Father. Remember, one of the nice lines I like, I think it's in Luke's Gospel, I think it's about chapter 21. Luke says, says Jesus to Mary Magdalene, go and tell my brothers that I ascend to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God. Whoa! God is our Father. That makes me a son or a daughter, you know. And to Jesus now, I'm a brother or sister. John understood that. He also understood that the gates of heaven have been opened to him, that sin has been destroyed, that Satan has been beaten. You know, all of these things, that he's now a member of the mystical body of Jesus, and he has an obligation then to go out and to share that word with other people. Baptism. Oh my goodness, the early church was so filled with that. In fact, in the early church, they didn't call it baptism. Baptism comes from the Greek word baptizein, which means to immerse, to plunge. But they used to call it illumination. You're getting illuminated. You're getting life. You're getting light into your life. You know, what a marvelous thing that is. You know, so, you know, it's a... a resurrection of your body, of your life, your soul, your whole spirit. And so happy Easter, you know, happy Easter. It's just a wonderful thing. I remember shortly after I read that story about John, I specifically went to my church, St. Simon and Jude in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, and I went in. The door was open, so I went in, but the baptistry was locked. And I stood outside and said to myself, here I found my Lord Jesus Christ. You know, many years ago, my mom and dad and my godparents brought me there. And a priest by the name of Father McClendon baptized me. And all of those marvelous, wonderful things happened for me. And it gives me the ability to overcome the absolute insanity in the world in which we live. You know, we can overcome that now because we have this power within us. When we're born, we are born into a world, the human condition, where we are separate from ourselves, separate from others, separate from God, separate from the universe or the cosmos. You know, we feel that separateness. And the real sad thing is we end up using all kinds of solutions that don't really work. John, on the other hand, chose Jesus as Lord and Savior of his life, and baptism became important. Here I found my Lord Jesus Christ. So Easter Sunday, the reunion of the body and soul of Jesus through the power of the Holy Spirit, it just took place kind of in the middle of the night. And as well for us, and gave Jesus a totally new life, and he gives us a totally new life as well. So rejoice in that. It's a marvelous thing. And spend some time reflecting on it. I was reading yesterday in a book called The Art of Prayer, an Orthodox anthology. And Theophan the recluse said, when you pray, do not end your prayer without having aroused in your heart some feeling towards God, whether it be reverence or devotion or thanksgiving or glorification or humility or contrition or hope and trust. And when after you pray, you begin to read, do not finish reading without having felt in your heart the truth of what you have read. So what he's saying is kind of melt into it, reflect on what you've just read or what you've just prayed, and allow it to become real, allow it to sink from your head into your heart, and there to take on life and to become something that does transform you at that moment and throughout the rest of the day and hopefully throughout the rest of your life. What a marvelous piece of wisdom from this Eastern monk, Theophan the recluse. Huh? So good to be with you again. Looking forward to be with you in future podcasts. Remember, happiness tomorrow always depends on doing the truth today. Today, we are an alleluia people. We are risen, this marvelous thing that the Father has done for his Son, Jesus. God bless. Good to be with you. Keep me in your thoughts and prayers. Know that you're in mine.